Some people use cheesy pickup lines, others romantic gestures, but this guy thought threatening to kill deputies would win him the girl of his dreams. Thanks for watching NBC2. I'm Peter Bush.
And I'm Lisa Spooner. So, Evan Maloney pretended to be the woman's boyfriend when he made the violent threats. NBC2's Joseph Vojo explains how the twisted love triangle landed Maloney in a square jail cell.
What would you do for love? Well, Evan Maloney posed as one man who lives on this boat and threatened to kill everybody in the Lee County Sheriff's Office. I spoke with one man today who knew Evan Maloney. He tells me that Maloney set up this man because he wanted his girlfriend.
He's upset, heartbroken, distraught.
Head over heels in love and willing to risk it all.
No, he wasn't right. It was stupid.
How stupid? The Lee County Sheriff's Office started getting messages from a man saying he assaulted his girlfriend and was thinking of murder. Then, the messages escalated, threatening to kill everyone at LCSO.
For someone who doesn't know him, that's terrifying. And that's horrible.
Using the man's name from the threats, deputies traced the messages to this North Fort Myers marina. But the guy they were looking for wasn't the one who sent the messages. Someone else was using his name.
It was blatantly obvious who it was.
The man had a hunch and told deputies to look into Evan Maloney. Deputies tracked the IP address the message was sent from, and wouldn't you know, it was Maloney's address that came up.
I think he just wanted to get back at the guy that was living on that boat.
I spoke to a man who knows Maloney. He suspects Maloney did it because he's in love with the other man's girlfriend.
He's just a guy whose heart was broken and he doesn't know how to deal with his emotions.
Deputies got a search warrant for Maloney's home. They found the evidence they needed to make an arrest and took him to jail.
He needs to get a dog or something, do some deadlifts and start doing jiu-jitsu.
And Maloney is still in jail tonight. He is facing charges for 6 counts of intimidation and sending written threats to kill in Lee County. Joseph Ojo, NBC2.